Hi there and welcome back to At Tony's Garage. I am Tony and today we are going to open the last big unbox from the ones over there. So if at the beginning of this movement I had 12 small boxes and 5 big ones, now we are going to open the last big box from there. And I had a sneak peek, pretty cool models. A large variety of models we will have, from racing cars, from Le Mans, from rally cars, limousines, old ones, new ones, American, Europeans, Japanese ones. So stay tuned because you are going to enjoy it. Okay, this is the box. Quite a heavy one, to be honest. I think it has more than 15 kilograms. So let's see what's inside. Okay, at the first glimpse, we have some Lamborghinis, we have some British ones, some McLarens, we have a nice Audi, and it's time for me to make a wall. Okay, so I unboxed all the models from that big box, and I will be honest with you, this is the biggest box with models I had until now. I have here 3 layers of model cars. This will basically mean that if it will be for me to film this entire unboxing in one clip, it will be easily something like 4 or 5 hours long clip, and nobody wants that because this is not Lord of the Rings or something similar. So I will have the same approach as in the case of that box full of LookSmart models, and basically I will unbox in each clip 2 columns, so you will have like a, I don't know, 10-15 minutes clip with a large variety of models, but not so many. That being said, let's get started. A sip of coffee first. And let's see what is our first model. So we will start with a French car. Title of this car is Citroën DC19. This is something that we all know, but it's called Pompiers de Paris. In Romanian, we will also call it Pompieri or something similar. In English, it's Firefighters, if I'm not mistaken. This is not a fire truck, hence my issue in finding the name, but it is still an intervention car. It has the siren. It is a very, very, very nice looking Citroën DC19, made by Vitesse. Vitesse is also a French manufacturer of model cars. Not the best one, but let's say it's quite average. But the details on this model are quite nice. You can see the interior, even if it's a simple interior, it has plenty of details. Having in mind it was a very cheap model car, I'm quite pleased with this model. You'll also have the exhaust pipes on one side. These very, very beautiful details on and this very, very beautiful design that the DC19 has. I'm quite pleased with this model. Another French car. Today we will have a French start. This model car is a racing vehicle made by Top Model Collection. Top Model is an old model car manufacturer. It was made in Italy, as you can see on the box. And in this case, this is a Gordini. Gordini, quite a rare model. You're not going to see a modern one too soon. This is the Gordini T24 that went at Le Mans, and it was a group winner actually at Le Mans in 1953. So it's a 70 year old car, but for the 53, it has quite a crazy design. Well, of course, the French are known for their crazy designs on their cars, but it's a good thing to know that they had this habit from a long, long time ago. And this is this little beauty. Top model, also not a premium manufacturer. Let's say that it is a medium one, but you must admit that those old rims are very, very well made. Quite some details on them. I really like those kind of rims. Very nice headlights, very nice interior. The steering wheel is very basic. Now, being 53, I'm not sure if this is how a steering wheel looked like at in that period of time, or this is something that top model made from lack of, I don't know, resources or something else. But nevertheless, a very nice looking model. And we will continue with Le Mans, and we will continue with top model, and we will continue with a French car, because this is another group winner at Le Mans, this time from 67, and we are discussing about the Alpine A210 or 210. Alpine still makes some racing cars, and very, very nice ones. At this moment, you'll also see them in Formula One car, in Formula One Championship. But this model, from my perspective at least, it's the most beautiful Alpine they ever made until now. I'm a big fan of them. This car won its group many times at Le Mans, and my purpose is to add all of them. And hopefully one or two of them I will manage to find from Spark, because Spark also made these kind of cars, and Spark provides a lot more details on their model cars. Of course, it cost twice or third time as much, but it's worth the money. Okay, moving quite fast to Spain right now, but also a French car. This is the Renault 10, another vehicle from the 60s. This is from 67, and it's in the livery of a police car. To be more specific, it's Guarda Civil, one of the oldest security departments in Spain. Quite nice details, very nice livery on this car. The engine was in the back, right here, where you can see those air intakes. Very interesting details. I like the interior. This was a magazine series, so quite a cheap model. This makes it even cooler, having in mind that it has plenty of details for how cheap it was. I don't know. I don't think it was more than 5-6 euros or something like that. Okay. We moved quite fast with this unboxing, so we can continue now with a Czech car from Czech Republic. This is a Skoda Octavia, a very good vehicle if you don't have a lot of money and you want a reliable car with a lot of space for your family, for your luggage, and with small price for the maintenance, and with a very, very good consumption. These Skoda models are made by Abrex, another Czech manufacturers for model cars. They are focusing on Skoda models, and I'm very, very pleased with this model. The quality of details is equivalent to the Mini Champs, maybe even higher, why not? You can see the seat belts. You can also see the seat belts in the back seats, and this is something quite rare. I really like this model car, and I really like all model cars made by Abrex. Until now, I had no complaints about Abrex and Skoda in general. Continuing with Abrex models and with Skoda, this is the smaller brother of the Skoda Octavia. This is the Skoda Fabia Kombi. This is actually the first model car that I received as a gift from the premium category, from the premium part of modeling, when I started collecting. Because until that moment, I only had magazine models. And when I had the opportunity to get this model, I was very, very happy. Another one with details, with some seat belts, with a great interior, very cool details on this car. And for the viewers that are not from Europe, This is actually a very affordable vehicle with, again, a small price, a small cost when it comes to maintenance. Cool, first column is already gone. Now let's go to some more serious stuff. And this is a Bang model. Made in Italy, long time ago. This is a Maserati 450S. Splendid looking car. I'm a big fan of Maserati and those racing car Maseratis from long ago. They were one of the best looking cars ever made, and this is a fine example of that. You'll need to be a connoisseur, and I'm not, but you'll need to be a connoisseur to watch a car like that from the distance and to know it's a Maserati, not a Ferrari or an Alfa Romeo, because all had quite similar designs at that in that period of time. But this Bang model has absolutely fantastic model, fantastic details. Look at the rims. Let's see if the camera wants to look at the rims. Look at the rims and how cool are they. Look at the exhaust pipes that you can see on each side of the model. Look at that great looking steering wheel that has a wooden wannabe feeling. Look at the board, very nice. The seats of the driver, the passenger seats that is covered, but it's still there. So you can see that as well. This is something very cool. You have the mirror right here, very small. Great details for this car. It's not that I have no complaints. I'm actually very, very happy with the details on this model car. Having in mind that it was also quite a cheap car, something like 15-20 euros. And for this kind of details, for such a beautiful car, it also has a stamp with aluminum wheels. So great details on it. This is something that every collector that likes racing cars should have. I really like this one. Let's see something American now. Something European American, because it is a Shelby Cobra or AC Shelby Cobra that was based on the AC model from UK, from box model, also an Italian car from Italian manufacturer, sorry. I also have a letter with a short description of the Shelby history and some details from about Carroll Shelby. Great stuff. This model is not as detailed as the one from Bang, but also a very cool one. This one went to Targa Florio. Targa Florio, great endurance race. Even if it's not a premium model, you can still admire a lot of details on it. Great livery. Great small windscreen. I love those exhaust pipes, and the front, of course, it is specific to Cobra, very, very aggressive. That wooden steering wheel, very nice seat details. Also, this seat is covered, but it is present here. The side mirrors, very nice details. Not a premium car, but nevertheless, very, very nice nice details. And I like the way that you can put this plexi box on. It will fit perfectly on the other model from this series, like that. Very easy. It will not go out easily. So it is good for collecting and for depositing like this. Okay. Another American car. This is the legendary Ford GT40, made by Bang. GT40 Mark II Stradale, or the version made for the road. With some dust on it, don't know why, but hey. You'll see it right here with the bonnet opened. I can close it if I want, but it has some little game here, and I need to have a lot of patience that I don't have at this moment. But the detail of the engine are quite nice. It's a very cool V8. This is something that I used to, and I'm still loving at this old car, that you are able to see the cylinders of the engine and to enjoy this great shape, especially for big engines like V8, V10, V12s. Something that you cannot see anymore in new cars, because they are all covered with plastic bodies. Other than that, the details are very nice, quite nice wheels. Not something premium, but a great addition to the collection. Moving back to Le Mans, this time with a British car, made also by Top Model. This is the Jaguar C-Type that went at Le Mans in 1953. This is the C-Type with the number 17 on it, and it achieved the overall second place at Le Mans. Great design, great details. I also have Jaguar C-Type from the same year, from the same competition, with the number 18, made by AutoArt. Well, that one won Le Mans in 53. This was the one that took the second place. And being an AutoArt, that is far more detailed than this one. But this does not mean that this car is not nice. It is very nice. I also love these rims. Great details, a lot cheaper than the AutoArt car, so no complaints here. Love those yellow greenish headlights. Quite nice model. At a certain point I might make a comparison between the Top Model C-Type Jaguar and the AutoArt C-Type Jaguar, but to be honest, I don't really see the point, having in mind that this was made many years ago and it has a very small price tag, and the AutoArt model, even if it's not something that you can call expensive, it was at least three times the price and made in more recent times. So I can only assume that the technology was better when they made it. Another gorgeous Shelby. I think this one, let's see if it's written on the box. It is not. This one, it went to Mille Miglia and not Targa Florio, from my memory. I hope my memory doesn't fail me this time. Awesome looking color. I prefer this blue over this beige, but they're both nice. This one does not have passenger seats covered. You can see both passenger seats. You'll have an extra bar here for security. The same details when it comes to the steering wheel, to the board interior. Very nice model. Not a premium one, but nevertheless, awesome looking car. It is one of my favorite American cars. Moving to another Le Mans winner, where actually this is the only Le Mans winner from this lineup right here. This is the McLaren F1 GTR, made by Spark or Hakete. It depends. If we took into consideration the amount of details and the price I got this for, something like $12, this is a Hakete model. Hakete model, it's a producer that made the D'Agostini series for Japan market. Extraordinary details compared with the models from the European market. This one are a lot better, but even if some model car sites sell this model as a Spark one, and even if it has the stand very similar with the Spark one and this plexiglass very similar with the Spark one, if you'll get a Spark model and put it next to it, you'll clearly see the differences between this Hakete and Spark wannabe and the real Spark model. That being said, usually a Spark model is around 60 to 75, 80 euros, and this was around 12 euros. Let's say if you'll not get it on sale, you'll manage to get it with around 20 euros. So still, 3 or 4 times more cheaper than the spark one. And this makes the McLaren F1 GTR a great addition to the collection. I love the history of this car. I love how nobody believed that it will win Le Mans, but the chances were with them. I also have the one that took the third place at Le Mans, is the yellow one with the Harrods livery from right there. And this is one of my all-time favorite model cars and cars, actually. It is in my top 5 all-time cars that were ever made. Nice. Now let's go to a Spark model, but this one I need to open carefully because as much as I like it, I receive it damaged and I don't want to damage it even more with my unboxing. So this is quite a rare model, the Morgan Aero 8. Morgan is a British manufacturer that makes cars mostly from wood, and since it is broken, I can take it from the stand because it has this part missing, or it is here, I need to fix them. But this means that I will show it to you without the stand. Having in mind this is a Spark model, the details are top-notch. It is hard to have a complaint for a Spark model. Great details, great design. I'm a big fan of Morgan cars. It is awesome to see a car like this. Usually they have some BMW engine underneath or another type of German engine. So even if they look robust, if they look like old cars, they are capable of going over 150 miles per hour or over 250 kilometers per hour. You have a lot more details when it comes to the board of this car. You'll also have the seat belts on, so it is a joy to check it out and to closely and to see how many details. You'll also be able to see the pedals, those three pedals, this being a manual, it has all three pedals in here. So yeah, it's too bad that it is damaged. At some point I will fix it, hopefully, but until then, all I can say about this car is that it looks absolutely great. Good. As promised, only two columns for this unboxing. This means that I will do shortly the unbox clip for these two columns, and so on and so on. Until then, cheers, thank you for watching. Bye.